study about this chapter. We are starting the chapter that is life processes, chapter 6, and we know about the autotrophic nutrition, that is photosynthesis of the green plants, okay, how they perform it. Now we study about the heterotrophic. We will study about the heterotrophic nutrition, and heterotrophic nutrition is what, as we know about it, that the plant or the animals or the living beings which cannot make their own food with the help of their own, they are dependent on the other for their food, that is heterotrophic nutrition. So different type of animals or different type of living organism, microorganism, so they take their food with the help of the other, like saprotrophic nutrition in mushroom, moons, they depend on the dead and decaying material for their food and they absorb it. Some are depends on the other, but they live on them and absorb the food, like parasitic mode of nutrition, example cascuda, or in agar plants ka example lete hain, that is the cascuda, amar whale, and in animals also it is present, like leech, ticks, louse. Lice are what, they are growing on the head and absorb the blood from them, and so this is what, this is parasitic mode of nutrition. So now what about the higher organism? In higher organism also multicellular organism, and there is a proper way of nutrition, there is a proper stage of nutrition, or a system is present there by which they can perform. So I am forgetting about the unicellular organisms. Unicellular organism like amoeba. In amoeba, they are the nutrition they get by their only one cell, because that is unicellular body. So all the functioning is depend on only one cell, and they absorb the food by finger-like projections, and digest the food. In paramecium, cilia are present, and they absorb the food. So, but in multicellular organisms, there is a proper organs are present, well-developed organs are present, by which the food which they take is going on a proper process and digested. So now we study about the well managed or well ordered system of the human being. This is the diagram of the human alimentary canal. Alimentary canal means what? Alimentary canal means a pipeline starting from the mouth to the anus. This is called as alimentary canal. So in human beings, the nutrition, first of all they take the food, and then it is digested, and then by the digestion nutrients are obtaining and absorbing by the organs and going to the blood. Okay, so first is what? First is digestive system. This is the digestive system. How it is working? First of all, the food is going to the mouth. Mouth is also called as buccal cavity. And in here, tongue is present. Salivary glands are present. Tongues and saliva, it works on the food. We chewing them with the help of teeth. And then saliva is mixes. Saliva contains some enzymes. That is called as thymine enzyme or amylase enzyme. And it works in a particular pH. Okay, and then it digested the carbohydrate. The first digestion is started from the mouth, and the simple sugar is obtaining by that is glucose. Carbohydrate with the help of amylase is digested, and glucose is obtained. When the bolus is formed, when semi-solid substances are formed here, it is going through this esophagus. Esophagus is called as food pipe. That is what? That is food pipe. There is another pipe also, which is wind pipe or trap. or glycosone, and that is called as the fat. You see, sometimes our mother are they take fast. Fast rakhte hain, and that time they cannot eat food. So how they get the energy? They get the energy from the liver. Liver, here the glucose is stored in the form of glycosone. When we are not eating, at that time it converted the glycosone again into glucose and gave us the energy even when we are not eating any food. So this is very important. And then while the gallbladder is present, liver then produces the bile juice, and it is stored on in the gallbladder, and from gallbladder there is a bile duct. From here the bile juice is going into the small intestine. Small intestine mein gallbladder se, pancreas se, stomach se sara jo juice hai wo jata hai. Pancreas is also very important. This is what pancreas. It releases the insulin hormone and glucagon hormone. So insulin jo hota hai, that is very important because it absorbs the glucose. When there if in our blood if insulin is not released from the pancreas, then glucose in our blood is increases and it is it causes the disease. That disease is called as diabetes. So that is important point, that diabetes is cured by the insulin, and if there is a lack of insulin, then diabetes can occur. So pancreas releases the insulin, which absorbs the glucose, and then the food is going into the stomach. Into the small intestine. In small intestine, what happens? There is absorption takes place. Absorption. Look at here. There are some stages of digestion. That is what ingestion. Then digestion. Absorption. Assimilation. And last is what? Assimilation. So in small intestine, assimilation absorption takes place. In small intestine, there are some finger-like projections are present, and these are called as villi or microvilli. From microvilli, the most of the food, the nutrients hain, that after the digestion the nutrients hame mile hain, they are going into the small intestine, and in the small intestine through blood capillaries jo nutrients hain they are absorbed into the blood. So this is what absorption. And in the blood cells, when it is absorbed and going all the cells of our body, that process is called as assimilation. When the energy or the nutrients are going to the cells of our body, that is called as assimilation. So in this way, nutrients we can get the nutrient, but the undigested material that is going into the large intestine and through anus it is releases out. This is the appendix, which is a vestigial organ of our body. In the early times, that is important because they eat the raw material, but now we are eating cooked material, cooked foods, so it is not useful for us. So anus, through anus, excretion is taking place. So this is all about digestion. Yeah, so this is what? This is the digestive system or the heterotrophic nutrition. Understand? That is what? In human beings, means we are also heterotrophic and we are dependent on the plants for our nutrition. So, in this nutrition or in this digestion, there are, these are the steps. What is that? First is ingestion, means intake of food. the small intestine through the microvilli, the absorption of the nutrients takes place and this is going into the blood. So this is absorption which is taking place in the small intestine. And then assimilation means the nutrients are now going into the blood, and through blood it is going all parts of the body, all the cells of the body, that is called as assimilation. And then